Hi, welcome to our dosage calculation video series. Now in this portion, we're going to take a look at what you've learned from a ratio and proportion and talk about how it actually applies to medication dosages. So let's do a quick review from our other portions. All right, a ratio represents just a relationship between two numbers. Now there's my favorite schnauzer in the world, Harley. Remember, that's 3 tennis balls to 4 Harleys, which I can hardly imagine living with 4 of her, but we've got 3 to 4. We take that same relationship, we write it as a fraction, that's 3/4, with 3 being the numerator, 4 being the denominator. Now we take the same thing and you write it as a proportion, we've got 3:4. Each one of those 3 examples are communicating the same thing, just using different symbols. So proportions represent 2 ratios or fractions that are equal. Proportions are solved by multiplying the means, the numbers in the middle, and the extremes. So we've color-coded them for you here, just as a quick reminder. You've got the extremes that are in that kind of pinkish color, and you've got the means that are in the flesh colors. Remember, always double-check your work. So when you get what x equals, you want to go back and plug it into the formula to make sure your answer is correct. Again, even in practice, I make sure that I have someone else check my math just to be extra sure, an extra safeguard to make sure I'm giving an appropriate dosage to my patient. Okay, so let's take one, acetaminophen. Now this one you may know by the brand name of Tylenol, but acetaminophen extra strength, 500 milligrams per tablet. So we know that 1 tablet has 500 milligrams. That's no different than 3 tennis balls and 4 Harleys. 1 tab, 500 milligrams. Now you turn that into a fraction, 1 tab, that's the numerator, 500 milligrams is the denominator. Okay, now I know you're thinking, wow, this is kind of moving slow. It always will in the beginning with me because I know the anxiety that's attached to math. So I want to make sure you're really solid on these concepts as we move through the next steps. Now the order reads, acetaminophen PO 750 milligrams every 6 hours. You have acetaminophen 500 milligrams per tablet. Okay, acetaminophen PO, that means per os, it stands for the Latin, by mouth. So that's what PO means. 750 milligrams is the amount the physician has ordered of Tylenol or acetaminophen they should receive every 6 hours. Now you might often see Q. Instead of the word every, you might see a lowercase q. That also means every or each 6 hours. So this is what the physician wants, 750 milligrams every 6 hours. What I have on hand is 500 milligrams per tablet. So 1 tab equals 500 milligrams. So how do you solve ratio problems? Well, hopefully these steps look familiar to you. You identify the known ratio and the unknown ratio. You set up the proportions, cross multiply and solve for x, then check the answer by plugging the result into the unknown ratio. Remember, the unknown ratio is the ordered amount by the physician. The known ratio is the medication that we have. Remember, 1 tablet has 500 milligrams. We're going to try and figure out how many tablets it takes to make the unknown ratio, the 750 milligrams. Now, I know you can probably do that math in your head, but that's why we picked an example like this to show you how and what the process is. So it's not so much can you do the math in your head. I want you to understand the process as we walk through it. So we're going to try it with X. First of all, you set this up. 1 tab is 500 milligrams. I'm trying to figure out how many tabs equal 750 milligrams. I'm going to multiply the extremes and then the means. That involves cross multiplication. So we always try to put the X on the left side. Just take that for what it is. It helps keep things in order. So we put the 500X on one side of the equation equals 750. Now we're going to solve for x. X needs to stand by itself. So in that step, we always divide the equation on both sides by the number that's in front of the x. So 500x divided by 500, 750 also divided by 500. Whatever I do to the left side, I need to do exactly the same thing to the right side. Now the x that's remaining is x equals 1.5. Now 500x divided by 500 is 1x, but you can always just write x. You don't have to put the 1 in front of it. Now we've got 500 into 750, and we've got 1.5 times. So x equals 1.5. Now stop and think for just a minute. First of all, before we check our work, does that make sense? With a tablet, could I come up with 1.5 tablets? Yes, that's reasonable. Could I come up with 1.134567 tablets? No, I can't break a tablet down to those small amounts. I can do a half a tablet, but I can't do tiny hundredths of a decimal place of a tablet. Now, if I was figuring up IV rates, that I can get down very precise depending on the type of pump that I have available. If it's a liquid measurement, I can use a cup, a little medicine cup that goes up to 30 mils. So I can do it pretty closely by order of 5 mils by 5 mils. If I need a more precise liquid measurement, then I would draw the liquid up in a syringe that whatever the right amount of units are that I can do that with. So you always have to think, hey, what format is the medication in? And does this make sense to give 1.5 tabs? Absolutely. Now, that fifth step is to always check your work. So go back and plug X back in. So you'll see we have 1 tab divided by 500, 1.5 by 750. Now we've plugged 1.5 in instead of where X was. We do the cross multiplication. We come up with 1 times 750 equals 1.5 times 500. Exactly. They're both 750, and 1.5 times 500 is also 750. So we know that the safe dosage is 1.5 tabs of acetaminophen for this patient. How often? Right, every 6 hours. Good job. 1.5 is the correct dose for our patients.